guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, this is one of my favorite videos to film. This is my Sephora holiday bonus event recommendations. So if you want to see the best products that I think you should get for the bonus event, then just keep watching. Guys, there's really something fun for me about recommending products to you guys for these sales. For those of you looking to spend money, the fact that I can help you, it exhilarates me. Quick deets about the sale. Like I said, this is the Sephora holiday bonus event. It is going to be starting November 1st. Rouge members can use their 20% discount. VIB members can use their 15% off discount. And then just regular insiders, you guys get 10% off. Rouge and VIB, it starts from November 1st to November 11th. Insiders, it is November 7th to the 11th for you guys. Use code HOLIDAYSAVE to redeem online. This is available in stores and online. As you guys know, the best makeup comes out over the holidays, so this is the perfect time for you to pick up some of the holiday makeup that you've been wanting and also to pick up gifts for others. So the way I made my selections for today's video are I just picked only holiday releases, as this is just a holiday bonus event, so I wanted to talk about my favorite holiday releases with you guys and ones that I think are just really good and worth picking up. You get a little bit of a discount on top of that, and I think you will genuinely love these products that I'm recommending. Just kind of looking at what I have sitting on my desk, we have a lot of eyeshadow palettes because you guys know that is my weakness, and I mean, in the holidays, the best stuff that comes out are the palettes. Let's start off with my girl, Pat. Of course, you guys know I'm going to recommend her newest, biggest Mothership palette. It is quite pricey, which I can understand why a lot of people don't want to purchase these full price. So I always recommend picking up any of these Mothership palettes that you've been buying while you can get a little bit of a discount. But of course, this is her newest big Mothership palette. And honestly, I wasn't too swooned away by these colors at first, but I do find myself reaching and loving for this palette because the colors are so wearable. You aren't going to regret purchasing this palette. It is so stunning. You have her special formula here, and you just have generally good wearable colors. This one is amazing, and I don't want to talk about it too much. I'm just going to link my review down below for you guys, and you can see it in action for yourself. Definitely, if you have been eyeing this palette, this is the perfect opportunity to get it. I love the Midnight Sun, and I definitely recommend the Midnight Sun. But if there's some older ones that you've also been eyeing over that one, this is a chance to get any of those. And she did release her holiday collection. She came out with 3 eyeshadow palettes. Now, the one I'm recommending to you guys is Nocturnal Nirvana. This one is the best one, if you ask me. I think it's the prettiest one, and it's the one that really excites me. Now, these are $60, so you definitely want to get a little bit of a discount while you can. This is a way to get her super special formula in a quad, and I know these colors aren't for everybody. They're so pretty, you guys, and the way they look together on the eye, like, I can't not recommend this to you guys because it's truly my favorite. It really is. Of the 3, it's my favorite. Sorry, I just checked online. These are $65. So, get some savings on them. But also, I do want to give a shout out to Ritualistic Rose, because of the 3, this is the one that I'm going to be wearing and using the most. So while I do love Nocturnal Nirvana the most, I mean, look at these colors. If you love a pink sparkly eye, you're going to love this. I'm not wearing this right now, but I have a pink sparkly eye on right now because I love those shades. So that is why I am recommending this one, because this one is a little bit more wearable. So if you are looking for more wearable colors, I recommend Ritualistic Rose. If you like a little bit of brighter colors or want to experiment more, I would definitely recommend Nocturnal Nirvana. And that's not to say I don't like Iconic Illumination. It's just my least favorite of the 3. So if you're really planning on what to spend your money on, I would recommend the other 2. This one is a little bit of an older palette, but I just have to talk about it briefly. The Natasha Denona Metropolis palette. This is a good value for what it is in the Natasha Denona line anyways. But if you do not have it and you want it, great opportunity. I just think if you want to try Natasha Denona. This is such a wonderful palette to have. You get such a range of colors. It's a little weird to look at first, but I've been creating the most pretty looks with this palette, and I just think it's the most perfect fall winter palette. Just seasonally, I love it for this season. The quality is A1 on these, and I don't know, I can't express my love for this palette enough. I love all Natasha Denona palettes basically, but there's something about this that just gets a little bit of extra love for me just because of all the colors you get, the value, and the quality is just phenomenal on this. So let's talk a little bit about the ABH palettes. I would definitely say don't pick up all 5 they've released in the last 2 months. I'm not going to recommend all 5 to you. I will say they all are great, but here are my personal picks. The Jackie Ina palette, I mean, this one did not get its real moment to shine before all the other palettes came out, but the colors in here are so beautiful, and I know by this time most of you have picked this up, but if you haven't, I just want to remind you that this palette is still out, it's still new, and it is a wonderful palette. It's stunning. It would make a great gift if you already have it for yourself, and if not, it's a great gift to yourself. So that's one I would recommend getting if you have not picked it up already. Now, I know you guys are gonna ask about the Carly Bible palette. I'm gonna be honest, I haven't even used it yet. I have it. I just think between the two, I like the Jackie Ina color story better. That's not to say this one isn't good. It's just personal preference. If you want to pick up both, go ahead. But this one is a little bit better for me personally. But Carly Bible is good. If you know you like that color story, then get it. ABH, of course, did release their 3 big ones. Do not waste your money and get all 3 unless you are like a true makeup artist and need these colors. Sure, if you've been wanting all 3, go right ahead, but no, you do not need all 3. Honestly, you probably don't even need 1, but I would recommend that you do pick up at least 1 of these 3 because the formula on them is so good. So I would recommend you pick the color story that speaks to you the most. And if none of these color stories speak to you, don't pick it up. For me personally, the one that I'm going to recommend to you guys is the Norvina Volume 3. And I know she looks intimidating, but this palette allows you to play, but it also allows you to wear actual neutral looks as well. When it comes to you guys, I think this is the one you are going to like the most. Though I'm not gonna lie, Volume 1 is low-key my favorite of the 3, so if you are into this color story, I totally recommend this one. Volume 2 was just not for me. If you ask me, it was the hardest one to work with of the 3, but I would recommend if you've been wanting one of the big giant ABH palettes, pick up at least 1 because the quality is super good. So whatever story speaks to you, pick that one up. Since you can actually get a discounted price on new makeup, I always recommend looking towards the luxury items that you've been wanting. So let's talk about my guy, Tom Ford. So he came out with his Soleil Neige collection, and he came out with 3 quads. I have 2 that I'm personally recommending to you guys. This first one is my favorite of the 3. I think it's the one that I'll use the most, and I didn't expect it to be, but I love the Soleil Neige quad. The look that I created with it was my favorite look of the 3 palettes, and I find myself going for more cool toned smoky eyes anyways towards this time of year. So this one just really is winter and snowy to me. I feel like the looks I create with this palette are even more pretty on the eyes than they look in the pans. Scoop this one up if you can because it's so good. If you're going to spend that much money and you just want something a little bit more unique, I would recommend Soleil et Lune because this one is like a really icy wintry palette, but I would say it's quite unique, especially compared to the other Tom Ford eyeshadow quads. So this one isn't my favorite of the 3, but it's the most unique. So as a gift, this is a very unique quad to be giving. And honestly, it's just very easy on the eyes. I do enjoy looking at this one. So let me briefly talk about the Huda Nude Obsessions eyeshadow palettes. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I've only used 1. The one that I've used is Nude Light, which is the one I used on my eyes today. And honestly, I don't really recommend this one. So just So you know, if you're looking at the three, I would not pick this one up. I'll go into that in another video as to why, but I have to recommend picking up either the medium or the rich. Even though I haven't personally tried these, just from watching other videos and seeing the swatches, I think these two are going to be the best ones. I don't want to talk about them too much because I haven't even tried them, but I wanted to recommend them to you guys because if I hadn't purchased these already, I would have purchased these in the sale because they are such stunning colors. They're brand new releases and they're really beautiful. So this is just a reminder that you can pick these up for the sale. Also, the Huda Mercury Retrograde, it should be available on Sephora while the VIB sale is going on. I will be picking that up during the sale and I recommend you do as well if you want it. Obviously, I cannot speak on the quality, but I purchased basically every palette that Huda comes out with. Pick it up during the sale if you're going to pick it up. I would recommend putting it in your basket as soon as possible because I feel as though it'll probably sell out because everybody's going to try and get it on sale. Believe it or not, we're done with the shadows. So let's talk about some more face products, a lot of powder products, but let's talk about the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Edit Ghost Palette. I mean, this is beautiful. I would recommend checking out my video on this if you have not yet seen it, but I did thoroughly enjoy this palette. It wasn't my favorite, but I look forward to these every single year. This isn't perfect, but I love it. It's so beautiful and soft on the skin. These are $80 every year, so the fact that you can get this on sale, like, yes, please. These are amazing. If you've been wanting to try the Hourglass formula, I definitely recommend picking this up. If you are more of a richer skin tone though, run far, far away from this palette. Unfortunately, Hourglass sucks and this just is not rich skin tone friendly, but if you are a pale, pale girl, the quality, like, you just can't deny it. So good. This is such an exciting palette. They also came out with a blush quad, and I don't recommend you pick up both because, quite frankly, you don't need both. But I would recommend picking up one or the other. If you feel like you just generally have a lot of Hourglass powders or you really like the blush formula, they do have a blush palette as well, which I thoroughly recommend. I personally have this because I just love the blush formula from Hourglass. So I'm loving this palette. I think the colors in here are beautiful. This is great for travel for me because these are the best blush formula. Don't need both, but whatever your needs are, this is a good time to pick up one of the two. I've been loving them. And you guys seemed quite curious. I just dropped my Tom Ford palette. I do not know how people have, like, hardwood floors in their beauty room. If I had hardwood floors, all of my makeup would be broken. I'm too clumsy for that. Thank goodness I have carpet. Okay, so a lot of you guys have seemed very curious about this palette when I mentioned it in a haul. This is the Laura Mercier Soft Cheek Canvas. Now, I just love this face palette. It's probably my favorite that's come out this year, and it's because it is just so pinky toned. So if you don't like a pinky blush, you are not going to enjoy this palette. But if you're like me and you love a good soft pink flush on the cheeks, this is so beautiful. I love the formula of this. It's what I have on right now. Today I used this on my cheeks and then this as the highlight. I don't know, just the aesthetic of it all and how beautiful it is. I definitely recommend it. I did not want this at first when I saw it, but once I saw it in stores, I was sold. So just keep that in mind that it is much prettier in person than it is online, because online it absolutely looked like something I didn't need, but in person it was a different story. So I'm loving this. I think it's awesome. And if you've been eyeing it, which a lot of you seem to have been, just so you know, it gets a thumbs up. It's really good. And the last couple of things are from Fenty Beauty. You guys seemed curious about these products, so I'm here to talk about them with you guys. So this is the Fenty Beauty Balm Baby 2. It's a mini lip and face set. So I think this is an awesome deal, and it's really neat because you get colors that are not in their original line. So if you like the formula of the highlighter and the lip gloss from their line, definitely recommend you pick this up. They have a fabulous lip gloss formula and a fabulous highlighter formula. So the fact that I could get two unique colors for a really good value, I mean, duh. So it comes with this highlighter in Sandcastle, and this is a beaming highlighter. So just be aware, if you have texture, this really shows it off. But if you're putting on highlighter already, you should kind of expect that. But like, this one really kind of emphasizes texture. But I have it just right on the tips of my cheekbone so that it really pops, because this is so freaking beaming. It's a really unique color, and if you like a really bright, shiny highlight, you are going to love this color. You also get a really pretty light champagne-y gloss. I love throwing these in my purse, and this is a great color to highlight your lip and also just to put over any lip liner, really. So I really like this color. It's quite universal. I think this is just a great set in general, and it's a great value without already getting the discount. You guys seem super interested in this one as well, and the colors in here are fantastic. All right, so time for my last recommendation for you. This is the Fenty Beauty Glossy Posse Set. This, I had no problems not getting a discount on this and getting it right away, because this is the most awesome set that Fenty has this year. They have top of the line lip gloss formula, and now you can get it in a bunch of colors, because honestly her line didn't have these lip glosses in a lot of colors, and I prefer spending less for less product anyways. These are great to keep in your purse. I throw them everywhere around my room. I'm currently wearing this hot pink one on my lips, so as you can see they are a little bit more sheer, but they're perfect if you want a bright lip. You now have a gloss that you can pair with it now. If you love like red orange lips, you're gonna love this one. You have a chocolate gloss, an iridescent gloss. Then you have Fussy, which is from the regular line, but it's one of the most universal lip colors, and this hot pink one, which isn't as hot pink and scary as it looks. So I think this set is wonderful. All of the formulas are the same Fenty gloss formula, just with a little bit of tint. I know this is crazy, but it was one of the value sets that I was the most excited for this year. So if you like that lip gloss formula, definitely pick that one up. So that's all I have for my holiday bonus sale recommendations. There are so many great holiday products out that I definitely think you should check out, but just of the ones that I've purchased, these are the ones that really are worth the money to me and that I genuinely think you guys will love. Let me know what you plan on picking up for the sale, whether it's a gift or if it's for yourself. I don't think I've mentioned this before, but if you guys shop the links I have in my bio, I actually get a small commission from that, which of course goes to my channel, nothing else. I'm just improving my content. So if you fill your bag up using my links, then I can continue to create awesome content for you guys. But of course, don't feel obligated to. If that just makes you feel not good inside, you don't have to do it. I don't care. Just for those of you who would like to go out of your way, it is a free way to support me. So that's all I have for today's video. It was so fun to film. I just, holiday makeup is so exciting to me. So thank you guys so much for watching my video. If you are not subscribed to my channel yet, I hope you do take the time to do so. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys, have a good one.